begin in 60 seconds.
Therefore, an honor and glory in the highest. Peace on earth, goodwill to all thou set of Galilee. To give good regard to thy brother and thy sister, and also to honor the King of Māori that holds that mantle as a servant of the Tiriti of Waitangi on behalf of all iwi Māori. I also pay acknowledgements to those of our loved ones that we've lost, and I say to them, moi mai, moi mai, moi mai, rest in peace. Therefore, to all of our distinguished guests, to all who have gathered here in this forum today, to listen to the voices, to listen to the discussions, to be able to give good thought under the sacred tongue of our Te Tiriti o Waitangi, I bid you. Greetings once, greetings twice, greetings three times. O reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou mai. Mai hara mai whakatau mai, kia rā no tātou katoa. Tēnā koutou nā.
Te aroha, te whakapono. Me te rangi mari e tātātātau e te aroha, te whakapono. Me te rangi mari e tātou,
tātou e. A tēnei anō e kia na a tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā rā koutou katoa. Ka huri te rā kia kia koe rā e tā whāna.
Tēnei au te hōkai nei o taku tapu ai. Te hōkai nuku, te hōkai rangi, te hōkai nei a tō tipuna atu matauinga. Atu kariri, atu kariwha, atu kaitaua. Taku tapu ai, ko tapu ai nui a tāne. pikite ai ki te rangi tūhāhā ki tihi o manono, i roko hina atūrā ko ngā kete o te wānanga, ko te kete tuauri, ko te kete tuate, ko te kete aroni, ka tiritiri a kā paupaua ki papatūānuku, ka puta tīra tangata ki te whaiao ki te ao marama, hui te marama, hui te ore. E aku nui, aku rahi, aku whakatamarahi ki te rangi, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Koutou e whakarau i kai, i raru i te mana, o te runanga, o te ao, tēnā ka mihi atu ki a koutou, me ngā āhuaranga o tō tātou nei ao. E tika ana me mihi atu ki ngā mate huhu o te wānei, aha kō ko wai, aha kō no hea. Ako koe tērā e wira, ka tahi anō ka nuku atu koe ki te rua kō iwi o mātu o tupuna. Engari ko te whakaaro ki a koe o tira koutou, e te hunga mate, moi mai rā, oki oki ai, ko rātou ki a rātou, ko tātou ki a tātou, nā reire huri rauna, tēnā no tātou katoa, e aku rangatira tēnā koutou. He mihi mai oha tēnei ki a koutou, i pupuri ai tēnei kaupapa. He ha tērā ko te oranga tonutanga o te iwi. Me te āta tirohia i te noho o ngā tangata whaikaha, ngā tangata haua, ngā whānau haua, ngā rere mihi ana ki a koutou, ngā ringaringa, ngā waiwai o ngā hāpori i whakatautokonia tō tātou nei hāpori o tātou nei tangata. Ngā rere mihi ana ki a koutou katoa, e mihi ana ki a koe te rangatira, ngā ue tuku mai te mihi ki a tātou katoa, he whakahokinga mihi atu i tēnei mai te kāwanatanga ki a koutou katoa. Nā reira kāre tēnei mōkai o koutou i hihi ki te whakatorongi ngā kōrero. Engari kā tika me whakahoki a ngā mihi. E rungi ngā tikanga i waihoti ake nei ngā mātu e ngā tupuna. Nā reira huri rauna, koutou ka tai a wairua, tai a ipurangi. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa. Tūtira mai ngā iwi, tātou tātou e. Tūtira mai ngā iwi, tātou tātou e. Whaiau te mararangi paha, me te aroha e ngā iwi, kia kapatahi, kia kaira, tātou tātou e. Nā rere, aku rangatira e tika ana ngā kupu kōrero o te amorangi iwi te tau huata. Tūtira mai ngā iwi, tātou tātou e, tēnā no tātou katoa. Kia ora.
Kia ora. Ena mana, ena reo, ena hau e whā, tēnā tātou katoa. Tēnā koutou, tēnā kōrua ngā kaikōrero, Mātua Ike, Mātua John, tēnā kōrua. Me te kai waiata, whai Ranel, o tō korokoro tūi, tēnā koe. Kia koutou katoa e hui mai nei, nau mai, haere mai. Ko wai au, ko Takitinu te waka, ko Ngā Rororo te awa, ko Ngāti Kahununu, ki Heretaonga te iwi, ko Groton, rawa ko Goddard, oko whānau tipuna, ko Tristram Ingham ahau, ko tangata whaikaha Māori ahau. Good afternoon whānau, my name's Tristram. I'm one of the governance members of the Independent Monitoring Mechanism to the UN Convention on the Rights of Persons with Disabilities in Aotearoa, and a moderator for this kaupapa. It's my pleasure to be here and to invite our Tiriti o Waitangi theme moderation Rōpū to mihi to you as well. Mātua Ike, kia ora, kōrero mai. Mātua Ike, rākena, mihi mai.
Hauri no tēnā rā kaitawa no e te iwi. He uri tēnei o tāne waka ki te tāo taku pāpā. He uri anō no Ngāti Whātua ki te tāo taku māma. Ko Ike rākena tōku ingoa. Ko ai te pautikanga mō tō tātanei iwi. Mō reira tēnā kaita katoa. On my father's side, I am Tainui Waka Waikato Iwi. On my mother's side, I am Mahu Ki Te Rangi Waka Ngāti Whātua Iwi. My name is Ike and I am Napau Tikanga Whāhui during this day. Tēnā rā koutou.
Kia ora mātua. Peter Allen.
Hai, kia ora te whānau. Rua hine ngā maunga a ka makaretu te awa. Te whenua ko Tagapau. Ko rākau tātahi te marae, ko tēnei ngā tānga o tōku tīpuna, ara tōku tūranga waiwai. I te taha o tōku matua, ko Russell Alpha James, ko Ngāti Māru, Ngāti Kahungunu ki Tamatea, me kaitahu ki te Waipaunamu. I te taha o tōku whaia, ko Ngai Tahu ki Tagapau, ara Tahuma Kakanui, ko te whatu i āpiti, e Ngāti Kahungunu ki Tamatea, me Rangi Tāne ki Tāmaki Nui Ārua. Ko Waiahau, ko Peter Allen ahau. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, kia ora anō koutou. Kia ora everybody, my name is Peter Allen. I hail from a little place called Tagapau over on the Hawke's Bay Plains, below the mountains of the Ruahine. Where our river flows called Makaretu, and our marae rākau tātahi lies on the side. These are the taonga I grew up with as a child through to young adulthood. That's where my father Rusty and my mother Ata brought our family up. Something else that I was passed on through my genealogy was a dystrophy for my eye condition, retinitis pigmentosa. And so as a young man, my vision was good, but now going into my 40s and 50s, my vision is deteriorating, and that's what brings me here today. That's what makes me he tangata whai kaha Māori. Nō reira, he mihi ki a koe, John. Kei te harita ngākau ki te kitea i a koe e hoa. Kua tai te wā mō tā taku mihi ki a koutou engari, tēnei te whakatauki. He whakatauki o ia iwi o iwa whānau o ia whānau. He aha te mea nui o te ao, he tangata whaikaha, me he tangata whaikaha Māori. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, kia ora nā tātou katoa.
Kia ora mātua. Whae Ranel Baker.
Tēnā tātou katoa, ka mihi nui atu kia koutou, ko Ranel Baker ahau. Te taha o taku matua tāne no te tai rapiti, te taha o taku koka no Waikato Tainui, me ngā kuhi tonu. Nō reira, tēnā koutou katoa. My name is Ranel. Whakapapa through to the east coast on dad's side, Waikato Tainui, and the north on mum's side. I grew up mainly in Tāmaki Makaurau, now residing in Te Tai Tokerau. I'm here to tautoko the process, our rangatira upholding tikanga for the process. I want to mihi to Matua Ike for being our pau tikanga today. And I guess I belong to Wakaturu whānau, so I'm a full-time power chair user as a result of muscular dystrophy, and my experience has meant that I've come along to be part of the discussion today. So tēnā tātou.
Kia ora whae. Paula Bernadette Jones.
Tēnā koutou katoa, ko Kuruha Pō Te Waka, ko Ruepehu Te Manga, ko Hongaihu Te Awa, ko Kawangaroa Te Marae, ko Marae Huatau Te Tūpuna, ko Bernadette Jones Ingham Takawingawa, ko Tangata Whai Kaha Māori Ahau. Kia ora.
Kia ora. Whaea Karen Pointon.
Tēnā tātou katoa. Ko ngā puhi te iwi. Ko Ngāti Hine te hapū. Hikarangi me rua pikapika, hoki mauna. Taumārere, te moana. Kawa kawa, te papakāinga. My father is Viv. And he was from Te Mahurere. My dear mother was from Kawakawa. And they grew up in a small, well, I grew up in a small area there near Waiomio. I come from a large whānau with many deaf members, 13 deaf members across our whānau from up north. And it's wonderful to be here for Karen Poitin, tōku ingoa. Kia ora.
Kia ora, whaia. Whaia Geneva. Hakaraia-Tino, kia ora.
Nā koutou, ka rere āku mihi mai o haki a koutou katoa. He uri a hau no ngā puhi, te aupauri ngā piawa hoki. E noho ana au ki tāna ki nā kaurau. Ko Geneva Hakaraia-Tino tōku ingoa, he tangata haikaha Māori a hau. Nō reira, tēnei te mihi, tēnei te mihi.
Tēnu koutou. My name is Geneva Hakaraia-Tino and I'm Taunata Whakaha. I hail from Northland Bay of Plenty. Have lived experience as someone who acquired a tetra with cerebral palsy at birth and grateful to wear many hats within the disability sector. Thank you.
Kia ora. Kia ora. Whaia Takuta Huhana Hickey. Kia ora whaia.
Kia ora koutou. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa. Ko waka tō te iwi, ko Ngāti Tahinga te hapū, ko Weraroa te marae, ko Karioi te maunga, ko Whaingaroa te moana, ko Huhana hau. Kia ora. My name is Huhana, Dr. Hu for short, and I'm a lawyer, human rights lawyer based here in Tamaki Makaurau. I just want to also acknowledge the passing of the late Dame June Jackson yesterday and of the 34 who passed today with COVID, just to remember them in our hearts as we go on this journey. I'm a wheelchair user and I identify as whānau hauā. Kia ora.
Kia ora whaia. Nā mihi, nā mihi. Nō reira, nā mai hari mai koe te kaikōrero i te karauna, i tēnei rā, mātua Brian Coffey, me tō rōpū hoki, mihi mai. We'll now pass the rākau to Brian Coffey, Director, Office for Disability Issues, to introduce himself and the other government officials supporting this kaupapa. Kia ora, Brian.
Kia ora, Tristram. Kia ora koutou katoa. Ko Aotea te waka. Ko Taranaki te maunga. Ko Tiati Awa ki Whanganui a Tara taku iwi. Ko Brian Coffey taku ngoa. Huhana, thank you for that news. about our whaea who passed away. That is news to me and sad for all of those of all of us in Pōneki, in terms of the support and guidance she's given over many years. I'm going to now pass across the screen to the officials that are present to introduce themselves, and then we will then I will do an introductory statement to follow that, and then we will pass to the questions and responses. So if I look across my screen, I can see Kelly Bensley as the first person to introduce herself.
Tēnā koutou katoa. Ko whakapūnake te maunga. I'm sorry, on my end, I'm not able to see the screen. I'm currently only seeing Brian at the moment. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Kia ora tēnā. I'll start again. Ko whakapūnake te maunga. Ko wairoa te awa. Ko takitimu te waka. Ko Ngāti kahu te hapū. Ko Ngāti kahununu te iwi. Ko Kihitu te marae, ko Kelly Bensley toko ingoa.
Kia ora, thank you.
Katoa. Kia ora.
Kia ora, Kelly. John Whanga, would you like to introduce yourself again, just briefly?
Kia ora tātou. Ko Maumau kai te maunga. Ko Waitirohia te awa. Ko Ngāti Rākai Pāka. Ngā whare rau o te tahinga o te rā, ko Ngāti Kahununu, ko Ngāti Rongo Mai Wahine ngā iwi, ko te waka tapu o Tākitimu, ko Kura Haupo ngā waka. I aku rangatira, tēnā koutou katoa. John Whanga, currently with the Ministry of Health, and just want to mihi to you all, and particularly a number of yous on the panel who I've had pleasure to engage with in the past, Tristram, Peter, ka hoki aku mahara ki o mātua e hoa, me tō whan, tō kāinga ki Takapau, me te hokinga mahara ki tō tātou tāua nei kura. Nā reira, koutou katoa i aku rangatira, he humāri e tēnei tangata ki te tū ki mui te aroaro o koutou, me tō koutou kaupapa nui. Kia ora tātou.
Kia ora. Thanks, John. David, Wales.
Te maunga, ko rua bahanga te awa, ko kura, ko manawai te waka, ko English, Irish, Scottish te iwi, ko David Wales takawangawa. Kia ora tātou katoa, I'm David Wales, I'm the National Director for Learning Support Delivery with the Ministry of Education. It's great to be here as part of this hui today. Kia ora.
Kia ora, David. For later participation, the sound wasn't coming through great, so.
Okay.
Ben O'Meara.
Tēnā koutou katoa, ko Māngari te maunga, ko Manukau te moana, ko Ngāti Pākehā te iwi, ko Ben O'Meara aho. I am a group manager in the Ministry of Education's policy group. I grew up in Tāmaki Makaurau and went to the school for the blind there before moving to Wellington.
Kia ora, Ben. Sean.
E ngā maunga, e ngā awa, e ngā waka, e ngā iwi, tēnā koutou katoa. No ingarangi, no kōtirangi, oku tīpuna. Engari, tipu ake au. A ki te whanganui ātara ki te upoko o te ika. Ko Sean McMaster, tōku ingoa. Tēnā koutou katoa. Greetings everyone, my name is Sean McMaster. I have English and Scottish descent. I grew up in Wellington, where I now live, and I work as a policy manager at the Ministry of Social Development, Te Manatū Whakahiato Ora. And I'm here today supporting Julia Bergman for Ministry of Social Development. Kia ora.
Kia ora, Sean. Now, I'm assuming Black Square is not a person from a government agency that I didn't know was arriving. Oh, Jasmine Morrison, passing to you.
Kia ora, Brian. Nei rā te mihi o te ngā kai ki a koutou katoa, e hui hui mai nei i tēnei ahi ahi. Oh, nōku te Waimārie, nōku te Hōnore ki te noho tahi i Wainganui a tātou. Tērā, tēnei rā te mihi, tēnei rā te mihi, tēnei rā te mihi. Ko Waiau, ko Poho te rangi te maunga, ko Matumako te awa, ko te Aohau te marae, ko te whānau a tāpuhi te hapū. Ki te taha o tōku pāpā, ko Hukurangi te maunga, ko Waiapu te awa, ko Hine Rūpe te marae. Ko Ngāti Parau, Ngāti Rua Waipu, Tūhaurangi, hoki ōku iwi. Nō reira tēnā koutou, ko Jasmine Morrison tōku ingoa. Kia ora everyone, happy to be here. Feel honoured and privileged to be part of this really awesome group and to tautoko this kaupapa. I am a whānau member, first and foremost, a parent of tangata of ngā tāne takiwātanga, and also a tuakana or a sister in the Rett syndrome community. And I am here on behalf of Waikato Enabling Good Lives as the director. Kia ora.
Kia ora, Jasmine. Kia ora, Paula from
Kati tēnā koutou e hoa tuatahi
Education Commission.
Sorry there, Chief. Tēnā koutou e hoa mā, ko Paula hau. A whakapapa, he rangitāne, he kahungunu, ki te wairarapa. A mahi, he tumuaki tuarua ahau ki te amorangi mātauranga matua ki te TEC. Ka mihi ki te hunga nā rātou tō tātou whare kōrero i whakatūwhiri tēnei rā. Tristram, Ike Mā. Ka mihi ki a koutou o te runanga nui o te ao, he honore nui tēnei nōku, kua tua atua hau te taha o ngā hoi roti ngā tarikāwanatanga ki mua ki a koutou i te rānei. Rea nō rā ko te mihi nui i a tērā ka tukuna te ki a koutou, te whānau hauā, te whānau whaikaha, koutou e kōkiri ana i enei kaupapa hei paenga mō te katoa. I'm Paula, I'm one of the Deputy Chief Executives at the Tertiary Education Commission, part of the wider education whānau supporting our day together. Just want to recognise everybody that's brought us together today in this language, in addition to recognising you all in the other language. And for the TC, we want to ensure that we design an education system where everybody receives what they need to be successful through the intentional design of the systems. Tēnā koutou.
Kia ora, Paula. Kia ora, Julia. I should have made you first because you're my boss.
Kia ora, Brian. Tēnā tātou katoa. Ko Julia Bergman takuingoa. Nō te ao mutu ahau. He kaiwhakahaere matua ahau ki te manatū whakahiato ora. Tēnā tātou. I'm Julia Bergman, originally from Te Awamutu, and I'm here as the General Manager for Policy at MSD, and it's lovely to be here today.
Kia ora, Julia. Claudia. Claudia, I don't think you've got taken yourself off mute.
Koutou katoa, ko Amerika te whakapaparanga mai, ko Georgia te whenua tapu, ko Aotearoa te kainga, ke Wellington o e noho ana. He Chief Advisor Disability o e Oranga Tamariki, ko Claudia Boyles toko ingoa. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Greetings, hi, my name is Claudia Boyles.
I hail from America originally, but Aotearoa New Zealand is my home. I'm the Chief Advisor of Disability at Oranga Tamariki, the Ministry for Children. I'd also like to acknowledge the members of the IMM and the importance of independent monitoring to hold government to account, and also express the privilege that I feel to work as a public servant in Aotearoa New Zealand at this time for an organisation that's making a shift to make sure that tangata whaikaha and whānau hoa are supported if they come into our care. Tēnā koutou.
Kia ora, Claudia. Bobby Bryan.
Ngā mihi nui a kia koutou e mana katoa tēnei hui, kia ora mātua aik motu karakia. Ko Hikirangi te maunga ko Waiapu te awa, ko Ngāti Parau te iwi, ko Ohini Waiapu tuku marae. Ko Bobby Bryan ahau. I am currently working with MSD and supporting the establishment unit at the moment. Ngā mihi nui ki a koutou.
Kia ora, Bobby. Ronnie Sione.
Hi, I'm Ronnie. I'm a member of People First New Zealand. I live in Auckland. And that's all for me. Thank you.
Kia ora, Ronnie. I thought you might have been an official, so I just gave you a job in government by calling on you.
Oh, no. I'm not a government official, thank you.
Okay, cool. That's all right. Thank you. Vicky Hall.
So, kia ora. I'm Vicky Hall. I work as an advisor on the disability rights team at the Office of the Ombudsman. I'm just here taking notes, and it's a real privilege to be here and to see everybody here. Thank you.
Okay. Kia ora, Vicky. I think I inadvertently just gave you a position in government as well.
Oh, thank you. I'll send you my bill.
Yeah, the check will be in the post. Jason Moses. Kia ora, Jason.
Kia ora tātou, he mihi nui tēnei ka koutou katoa, he uri tēnei ngō Ngāti Awa nō Tūhoe, ko Jason Moses tōku ingoa, mahi ana i roto i te Manatū Hauora, Māori Crown Relations. Kia ora everyone, Jason Moses, Ministry of Health, working in Māori Crown Relations.
Kia ora, Jason. Ariana. Ariana from ACC. We'll skip over to Luke McMahon.
Tēnā koutou katoa, ko Araki te maunga, ko Waimakariri te awa, no Aototahi aho, ko Luke McMahon tōko ingoa. No reira, tēnā koutou katoa. I'm Luke McMahon. I'm Manager Strategic Policy at Arapoto Māotearoa Department of Corrections. I'm here today supporting DCE Health for Corrections, Juanita Ryan.
Kia ora, thank you. Zena.
Kia ora everyone, my name is Zena Sargeson. I'm an advisor with the Office of the Ombudsman.
Okay. Kia ora, Zena. We're recruiting for government here. Sally Jackson, I think you are an official.
Kia ora, Ko Sally Jackson, aho, post-COVID voice. Why can I tōko kāinga? Excuse me, but if I talk anymore, I'll start coughing. Thanks.
Thanks, Sally.
I just wanted to acknowledge you for a lot of the organising of people to be here on behalf of the government. So thank you. Hannah Kerr.
Okay.
My name is Hannah, I'm the Group Manager of Health at the Hospital of Scotland. But I was here in the economy as far as I was concerned.
Kia ora, Hannah. Thank you. And again, you weren't coming through very clearly, so if you're going to participate later, just check your microphone. And any other officials that I missed?
Hi, Brian.
Kia ora.
Tēnā koutou rauranga te rama, huri noa I te hui topa nei. Ko Moihau te maunga, ko Waihau te awa, ko Tainui te waka, ko Ngāti Maru, ko Ngāti Airihi, ko Ngāti ko te mana nā iwi, no Hauraki ahau. Ko Anita Ryan toko ingoa, he kaiwhakahaere mātua rōpū hauora I Ara Pautama, toko tūranga mahi. So I head up the health services for Ara Pautama, or corrections if you like, and just want to also acknowledge the IMM members. Like some of my colleagues, we are also on a journey within Arapautama to address the overrepresentation of Māori within our prison and community context, and our new strategy Hokairangi has oranga or well-being at the middle, in the heart of it. Very much looking forward to the next couple of hours with you all. Ngā mihi.
Kia ora, thank you. Have I missed anyone else?
Oh, tēnā koe, Brian.
Oh, Erin, sorry.
Aroha mai, I just had one of our AGL leadership call on the wire, so just been having a kōrero and supporting and giving manaaki to some of our leadership. Tēnā koutou katoa, ko tūro tō rawa ko whakatere o ku maunga, ko waima rawa ko te puna o haewai o ku awa, ko ngā toki mata whaurua toku waka, ko ngā puhi toku iwi, ko ngā tirangi rawa ko te mā hurihuri o ku hapu, I te puaki ahau ki o tautahi, he whānau whaikaha ahau, ko Aila Takawana Hira. Kia ora, I'm Erin Black and I'm the program lead for systems transformation here in disability support. Kia ora.
Kia ora, Erin. Okay, so passing back to the other side.
Kia ora. Kia ora. Having opened our session with appropriate tikanga, as best we can do for the days of COVID on Zoom, I'll now hand the rākau to the IMM Session Chair and Disability Rights Commissioner, Paula Tesoriero, to introduce the kōpapa for this session. Tēnā koe I te rangatira.
Nā mihi ki a koe mātua, Tristram. Kia ora tātou, ko Strombly te maunga, ko Kairawhiti te moana, ko Kapiti te kāinga, ko Te Tai Ora hio te moana, no Kapiti ahau, kei Wellington, tōko kāinga e nāianei, ko Paula Tesoriero tōko ingoa, ko Oti Kaihutu, tika hoatanga mō te kāhui, tika tangata ki Aotearoa. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Nā mihi Ike, mātua Ike, mātua John and Whae Aronel for setting the pathway for this really important session. This is our first actual session of questions and answers after we made some opening speeches along with the Minister for Disability Issues this morning, who also made some opening statements. I'm just going to very quickly run through how this session will work, primarily for observers who are listening and will be sending questions in for consideration later. Part one, which we are currently in, will have an opening statement from the IMM Ropu, followed by an opening statement by the government. And There will be a series of questions. There'll be six questions that will be asked by the IMM Ropu and answered by the government. We'll then move into part two, where observers will have a break and government participants will have a break while the IMM deliberates and reflects on the answers that have been provided by government. And we will formulate some supplementary questions. We'll also be taking questions from people who are listening. So I encourage those who are listening to use the Slido app and to send your questions in through Slido. The instructions for Slido are in the same instructions that you would have come into the forum on through Zoom. We won't be able to answer all your questions, but we will certainly be noting them, and the IMM will work through some of those questions and incorporate them into supplementary questions. And those supplementary questions will be asked under part three of our session. It's intended that we complete all of those parts by 4 p.m. today. I'm now going to hand back to Matua Tristram to provide the opening statement for the IMM Te Tiriti Theme Ropu. Tristram.
Kia ora Paula. Ka tangi te titi, ka tangi te kaka, ka tangi hoki ahau, tihei mauri ora. Pūrākau, storytelling and oratory are at the heart of expression in te ao Māori. However, the story we're about to share is not one to be proud of. We're here today as representatives of our whānau, hapū and iwi, as tangata whai kaha Māori or whānau hauā, these being two of several te reo terms for disabled Māori. And for clarity, we may use these terms interchangeably today. And we're here on behalf of our whānau and our allies. We're here to give a voice to tangata whai kaha Māori and our whānau, and to seek renewed commitment from te kāwanatanga o Aotearoa, the New Zealand government, to address the continued impact of inequitable outcomes in all areas of our lives. Māori experience higher rates of disability, and because Māori are a younger population, impairment rates are less likely to be linked with age-related conditions. The 2013 New Zealand Disability Survey results showed that when adjusted for age, the rate of disability among Māori was 32% compared to 24% in the general population. The most common types of impairment were consistent with the general population, being mobility and hearing impairments. However, Māori are more likely to experience learning difficulties, psychological or psychiatric impairments, difficulties with speaking, vision, and intellectual or learning disability. Māori have the highest prevalence of mental illness and addiction of any group in Aotearoa, are more likely to experience mental distress, and have higher rates of suicide. For example, Māori females were the highest group of New Zealand adults diagnosed with an anxiety disorder at 24% compared to 19% for European females and 12% for Pacifica females. Equitable access to government services, including healthcare and education, remains a concern. For example, more Māori children are disabled than non-Māori, 15 versus 9%. And yet, of the 10,496 students involved with the Ministry of Education ongoing resourcing scheme, ORS, in New Zealand in 2021, twice as many were European Pākehā disabled children, 47%, versus only 26% tamariki Māori. Tangata whai kaha Māori and our whānau are the most deprived citizens in Aotearoa, twice that of the total disabled people. Disabled Māori adults have lower incomes than other Māori, with over two-thirds having personal annual incomes of $30,000 or less in 2013. This is further compounded by lower rates of participation in the workforce and higher rates of discrimination. Stable and appropriate housing is important for well-being and linked to income and affordability. Housing ownership rates were lower for disabled Māori when compared to other Māori and non-Māori, while secure tenure for accessible rental properties remains a system-wide issue. The ongoing effects of historic injustices and discrimination are still being felt. More worryingly, however, contemporary shortcomings in government responsiveness to tangata pai kaha Māori, me o rātou whānau, also need to be brought to light throughout this forum. For example, the impacts to tangata pai kaha Māori and whānau hoa in the management of the COVID vaccine rollout, the response, and in the COVID protection framework, many highlighted in the Hau Māori COVID-19 priority report, have highlighted significant oversights and weaknesses in the COVID response for Māori and particularly for tangata pai kaha Māori. Put simply, disabled Māori, including in the most affected areas such as South Auckland, have not had appropriate voice, have not been counted, have not been prioritised, and have not been appropriately planned for, nor adequately supported. When considered together as intersecting issues, it's hard to separate the pervasive impacts of colonisation from the high rates of disability and poorer outcomes experienced by Māori in the present day. Disability is not a Māori concept, and we're only just beginning to define our own narratives that will help shape the future within the context of system-level transformational change. Te Tiriti o Waitangi is Aotearoa New Zealand's founding and first rights-based document between the Crown and Rangatira Māori. While the UNCRPD, the Convention on the Rights of Persons with Disabilities, gives explicit recognition to Indigenous peoples through Preamble P, the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples, also affirmed by Aotearoa in 2010, further complements New Zealand's constitutional obligations under Te Tiriti. UNDRIP Articles 21 and 22 instruct states to pay particular attention to the rights and needs of Indigenous elders, women, youth, children, and disabled people. This session aims to cast the light onto and to re-establish the New Zealand government's commitment to realising the intent of the UNCRPD for disabled Māori by developing approaches that give practical effect to Te Tiriti o Waitangi, that ensure that tangata pai kaha Māori, me whānau hoa, are provided with sufficient voice, time, and resources to facilitate their genuine and meaningful involvement in the development of all disability-related policy and legislation. They give respect to tikanga Māori, customs and practices, and cultural inclusion for tangata pai kaha Māori, me o rātou whānau. That enable tangata pai kaha Māori to access equitable and culturally appropriate services. That ensure tangata pai kaha Māori have rangatiratanga to exercise their authority to improve their health, well-being, and to pursue pathways towards thriving futures. In the words of esteemed Ngāti Hine elder and leader Tā Himi Henare, we implore kua tawhiti ke tō haerenga mai, kia kore e haere tonu, he nuhi rawa o mahi, kia kore e mahi tonu. You have come too far to not go further. You have done too much to not do more. Tēnā koutou katoa.
Namahi nui matua Tristram. Can I ask you, Brian, please, to make an opening statement on behalf of the government?
Aye. Tuia ki te rangi, tuia ki te whenua, tuia ki te ngākau o ngā tangata. Ko te mea nui, ko te araha, tihei Māori roa. Write it in the sky, write it in the land, write it in the heart of the people. The greatest thing is love. Let there be life. Kia ora koutou, Paula, Tristram, and Ike, and the rest of the panel, ngā mihi mahana kia koutou, and to my colleague officials, ngā mihi anō. I'm going to make some opening points of context for the questions that are being asked. And then we will respond to the questions as we said, and move forward as the agenda indicates. So in terms of context, Aotearoa New Zealand will not be able to claim progress on implementation of the United Nations Convention for Persons with Disabilities if we can't also demonstrate that the transformational changes underway and that are still to be progressed uphold the treaty principles of tino rangatiratanga and partnership. Even more importantly, we are not progressing the UNCRPD and Te Tiriti if over time we are not able to demonstrate that tangata whaikaha Māori whānau haua are living good lives as Māori. Your questions ask, to what extent does the government believe it has upheld? Given the aspirations of Te Tiriti and the convention, this is forever a shifting goalpost with no fixed endpoint, and we should always be looking for opportunities on where we can improve. What may have been regarded as significant progress in 2008, 2018, and now will be very different to what we might regard as progress next year and in the years ahead. Central to the success of taking EGL systems transformation to scale, establishing the new ministry and its ongoing work for all disabled people will be the voice of disabled people, tangata waikaha Māori and whānau family at all levels of the system, governance, direction setting, commissioning, both nationally and within communities. Lastly, is the questions related to partnership, progress will need to be made through partnership. Kei te tika te kōrero I o tātou tūpuna. Nau te rauro, nāku te rauro, ka ki te keti. So in the words of our tīpuna, with your basket and my basket, the keti will be full. As the voice of all disabled people in their whānau is designed deliberately into the policy and systems changes, there are important issues that will need to be considered. These include, who speaks for tangata whaikaha Māori whānau haua? What mechanisms will best mandate the representation of tangata whaikaha Māori whānau haua? How will we build on the strategy and strengths of Te Ao Marama and the work of Kapo Māori Aotearoa, who as a disabled persons organisation has given voice to tangata whaikaha Māori whānau haua over many years and will continue to do so, along with other non-government organisations? How can Māori for Māori organisations, leadership groups and other fora also benefit from the so far untapped leadership capability of tangata whaikaha? How best do we align Te Tiriti and the convention? I want to thank officials participating today in this session and in the sessions later in the forum, in particular Ministry of Health and other agencies with a quite key role in responding to COVID and the disability transformation work. It is a time when setting aside time to participate and contribute to this forum has been important to do, but also challenging.
We introduced a number of officials this afternoon. All of them may participate in the afternoon, and so I think it was important to introduce them all. I should also note that in preparation for the forum, at last count, over 70 officials across government have been involved in supporting the forum, either through preparation or indirect participation. As we go through the questions, officials in attendance will talk to the work that their agencies are leading, which demonstrates in action the commitments that the questions speak to. I think that some of the questions may take longer to respond to than the allotted 10 minutes, and others less. From this point, we'll have the questions. I will call out agencies who will respond to the questions, but others may want to contribute as well as the questions are asked. Kia ora, Paula, back to you.
Nga mihi nui, Brian. Thank you for your opening statement, and thank you also for your leadership across government on disability issues and for assisting the IMM to bring this forum to life today. Thank you for all of your work, and thank you to all of the government officials who are here to participate in this dialogue. Can I also thank you, Matua Tristram, for your leadership and for the work of the IMM Te Tiriti themed Ropu, who have put hours into the preparation for today's forum to bring issues of significance to the government for tangata whaikaha, Māori and whānau hoa. So, nga mihi nui. Just two very brief statements before we get into the questions. One is, I meant to say at the start, we have apologies from one of the trilingual interpreters who we wanted to have for this session, but unfortunately, due to poor weather conditions, the internet in the area has gone down. So just want to thank our two interpreters that we have today for being here and supporting this forum. And secondly, just want to say that in this part of the forum, there'll be a question asked by the IMM Ropu and responded to by government, but there won't be dialogue sort of to and fro in this part, although if I need to seek any clarity as the chair, I will do that. But other than that, it will be a fairly formal question and answer session, and then there'll be a chance for interaction in the third part. So I'm now going to turn to Tristram Ingham to ask the first question on behalf of the IMM Ropu. Tristram.
Tēnā koe, Paula, thank you. Question number one. In relation to tangata whaikaha Māori, whānau hoa, and disabled Māori, to what extent does the government believe that it has realised the purpose of the UNCRPD, Article 1, to promote, protect, and ensure the full and equal enjoyment of all human rights and fundamental freedoms by all persons with disabilities, and to promote respect for their inherent dignity? Kia ora.
Kia ora, Tristram. Brian speaking. I'll respond to that question. In responding to this question, it should be noted that in some ways it is also a response to question 5 around disaggregated data, as the response to this question is based on the data that we've recently put together, and that informs this reply. It was mentioned this morning that one of the important mechanisms that both the UNCRPD and the New Zealand Disability Strategy speak to is the need for better disability data. And we've worked together with representation of the IMM, disabled people's organisations as well, Stats New Zealand, other government agencies and academics since 2014 to pull together improved data to inform policy. ODI has been populating its website with data sets that align with the outcomes of the New Zealand Disability Strategy. Sharma, who's our senior analyst, who unfortunately left at the end of last Friday, one of the last pieces of work that she had to complete was to bring together a data set representing the experience of tangata whaikaha Māori. There are more than 40 measures reported on this, and it will be up on our website today. Many of these measures compare outcomes between tangata whaikaha Māori, non-disabled Māori, disabled non-Māori, and non-disabled Pākehā. Unfortunately, the data tells a story of much more to do. And so this is in direct response to your question, Tristram. Much more to do for tangata whaikaha Māori and their whānau. Across the tangata whaikaha Māori data set, many of the differences are small and may not be significantly different from a statistical sense, but the overall trend when all measures are considered together is sobering. Even more sobering is that this data presents the experience of real people across the motu and in our communities. As I said, most of the data shows that the difficulties of tangata whaikaha. The exception is the November 2021 vaccination data. And this is a good call out, as I think Dr. Jonathan Godfrey spoke to this morning, that real data linked quickly can help policymakers. And the November 2021 vaccination data bucks the trends of the other indicators in the data set. Tangata whaikaha Māori were accessing vaccinations at a rate above that of non-disabled population, both Māori and non-Māori. As I said, the data sources that are drawn together into this data set, 37 of the measures reported are drawn from Te Kupuinga, a Stats New Zealand post-sensual survey of 8,500 adults of Māori ethnicity and descent. Te Kupuinga gives an overall picture of the social, cultural and economic well-being of Māori people in Aotearoa. The survey provides key statistics on four areas of Māori cultural well-being: wairuatanga, spirituality; tikanga, Māori customs and practices; te reo Māori; and whanaungatanga. The survey, the data set also draws on the Youth 19 survey, the 2018 census, and as I said previously, the analysis on vaccination rates undertaken by the Social Wellbeing Agency and the Ministry of Health commissioned Horizon survey. So the topics in the data set, and as I say and stress again, are focused on education, accessibility, understanding and use of te reo Māori, employment and financial protection, justice rights and protection, attitudes, health and wellbeing, COVID-19, civic participation, practices and views towards Māori culture. The data will be published on the ODI website today, and I expect that the director of ODI will speak to this. Yes, I am, this afternoon. in direct response to your question, Tristram, much more to do, and that's based on the hard work of bringing together a lot of data sets, and sadly the experience, those data sets represent the experience of tangata whaikaha and their whānau.
Ngā mihi, Brian. I don't have any clarifying questions. I'm now going to move to question two and ask Peter Allen to ask the question.
Hey, kia ora nā, kia ora noa, tātou katoa. Ko tēnei te pātai tuarua o koutou. Question two. To what extent does the government believe it has upheld the treaty principles of the guarantee of tino rangatiratanga and partnership, and thereby realised Articles 4, 21 and 30 of the UN CRPD, in enabling, supporting
and resourcing tangata whaikaha Māori, whānau haua and disabled Māori to self-organise, collectively determine priorities and exert rangatiratanga across their own lives in culturally relevant and meaningful ways. Kia ora.
Kia ora, Peter. I'm going to ask the Ministry of Health to talk to the work of Te Ao Marama and Oranga Tamariki to talk to the work that they're doing. The summary response to this is there's much more further engagement to continue. I think the answer is also in that if we think about the last 4 years, the amount of engagement with tangata whaikaha is significant. I can't think of any major disability work programs, be that service development or policy development, where tangata whaikaha have not been at the table by intention. And in some ways, looking at the people on the other side of the panel, I think I work with them more often than I might my own team, as an indication of realisation of this answer, of this question. So I'll hand over to the Ministry of Health to speak specifically to Te Ao Marama as a demonstration of this, and to Oranga Tamariki.
Kia ora koutou katoa, tēnā anō koutou. The Ministry of Health is committed to fulfilling the special relationship between Māori and the Crown under Te Tiriti o Waitangi. Our Te Tiriti o Waitangi framework and position statement is the foundation of our approach to achieving mana whakahaere, mana motuhake, mana tangata, mana Māori. The principles of Te Tiriti o Waitangi, as articulated by the courts and the Waitangi Tribunal, provide the framework for how we meet our obligations under Te Tiriti in our day-to-day work across the health and disability system. These principles are tino rangatiratanga, equity, active protection, options and partnership. Within this overall approach, Whaia Te Ao Marama is the Ministry's Disability Action Plan. It is a culturally anchored approach to supporting tangata whaikaha and their whānau. Its vision is that tangata whaikaha pursue a good life with support. The goals and actions outlined in the plan are based on the principles of Te Tiriti o Waitangi and reflect Aotearoa's obligations to the UNCRPD. They also align with the vision and principles of enabling good lives. Whaia Te Ao Marama was developed in partnership with Māori disability stakeholders and with the oversight and endorsement of Te Ao Marama, the Ministry's Māori Disability Advisory Group. Last year, the Ministry of Health entered into a new contract with Te Ao Marama or Aotearoa Trust. This contract. This contract is affecting amongst tangata whaikaha. This is an example of the Ministry's commitment to te rangatiratanga in partnership and to Articles 4, 21 and 30 of the UNCRPD. Te Ao Marama is actively involved across the Disability Directorate and the wider Ministry, including the national implementation of the Enabling Good Lives approach to disability support services, work to improve the data available on disabled people and tangata whaikaha and the COVID-19 response. Can I quickly add to that too, that the work we are undertaking in the health reforms also provides a strong platform for progressing equity of outcomes for tangata whaikaha Māori. The health reforms, and in particular the establishment of the Māori Health Authority, will enhance tino rangatiratanga for Māori over haumoro Māori and ensure greater influence throughout the entire system, health system. It includes strengthening mana motuhake for whānau, supporting them to take control of their own health and well-being. This is consistent with Articles 4, 21 and 30 of the UNCRPD. The Paiora Bill, which is currently going through the House, requires that there be dedicated health strategies for Māori, Pacific and disabled people, tangata whaikaha Māori who sit at the intersection between two of these priority populations will be a key population of focus. And I might add too that we currently have a Māori health direction and policy in whakamaua, which sets a very clear commitment for the government to both Te Tiriti o Waitangi and Māori health equity. Finally, if I can just add that the work we are doing in response to the recent Waitangi Tribunal report on haumaru, the Tribunal recommended that the Crown urgently improve its partnership data and communications alongside tangata whaikaha me whānau haua. The Ministry is currently connecting directly with tangata whaikaha me whānau haua claimants from the haumaru COVID urgency process and will be hosting a dedicated kaupapa Māori workstream to address these data gaps. Kia ora.
Kia ora. Oranga tamariki.
Kia ora.
Claudia.
Yeah, thank you. Oranga tamariki is currently undergoing an organizational reset and we're in a bit of an evolving process. Oranga tamariki's ministerial advisory board released their report, Hopo Kingia Ki Te Kahu Aroha, Hipo Kingia Ki Te Katoa, on 30 September 2021. The Minister for Children, Honourable Kelvin Davis, announced that the government would accept all the recommendations in this report. One of the overarching recommendations was that in order to lead prevention of harm to tamariki and their whānau, collective Māori and community responsibility and authority must be strengthened and restored in a way that is fit for purpose within a modern and future context. This means shifting decision-making and resources to communities with tamariki, rangatahi, and whānau at the centre. An example of rangatamariki enabling, supporting, and resourcing rangata whaikaha Māori and whānau hoa to self-organise, collectively determine priorities, and exert rangatiratanga across their lives in a culturally relevant and meaningful way is the re-signing of the Strategic Partnership Agreement with Ngāi Tahu. Tauira's determination to change the agreement was premised on abolishing the master-servant relationship, wherein the one with the resources dictates the terms of the agreement and the allocation of resources. The new agreement provides for 25.9 million of funding over 3 years, with a greater focus on prevention and early support to prevent tamariki and their whānau coming into care. The funding supports development of whānau as first navigators initiative, aimed at addressing the upstream risk factors for poor outcomes that overly impact Māori through the social system. The initiative provides opportunities for whānau to engage with the appropriate services and support to enhance their well-being and whānau rangatiratanga. For us to implement the Ministerial Advisory Board's recommendations, we have a Future Direction Action Plan, and there are five key areas of the action plan that draw together themes from the board's interviews and findings, recommendations from previous reviews, and from the Waitangi Tribunal report. These key areas are organizational blueprint, people and culture, relationships, partnering, and decision-making, social work practice, and data insights and evidence. As Paula said earlier in her opening remarks, every policy is a disability policy, and I'm here to ensure that every focus area is a disability focus area, so that perspectives of disabled people imbue the focus areas and the policies and the resource allocations that result. As part of the Future Direction Action Plan, we're committed to upholding the treaty in this work and acknowledging Mātauranga Māori, as well as addressing the inequities faced by tangata whaikaha Māori. Kia ora.
Kia ora, Claudia. If there's any other agencies that want to speak briefly to their work in relation to this question, otherwise we'll hand over to Paula.
Kia ora, Brian. Thank you. I just have one. Oh, sorry. Is there a question? No. I just have a clarifying question for John. John, thank you for that kōrero. Can I just clarify with you as to whether there are any tangata whaikaha Māori, disabled Māori, on the Māori Health Authority?
On the board?
Correct.
The current board, yes, no, not that I'm aware of, no.
Okay. Kia ora, thank you, John.
Over to you, Paula. Question three.
Sorry, Brian. I'm now going to move on to question 3, and I'm going to ask Bernadette Jones to ask that question for the IMM Oropu. Bernadette.
Kia ora, Paula. Question 3. To what extent does the government believe it has upheld the treaty principle of the guarantee of tino rangatiratanga and thereby realised Article 4.3 of the UN CRPD through its actions in seeking, receiving and implementing tangata whaikaha Māori whānau hoa, disabled Māori perspectives in the development of all legislation, policies and decision-making processes?
Kia ora, Bernadette. I will respond briefly to that. Just in clarification, the response that we'll be making is around legislation and policy related to implementation of the convention and focused on disabled people, because I think that's what the convention says in relation to that article. So again, I would just say that there has been no significant policy or service development for disabled people in Aotearoa, where tangata whaikaha have not been at the table. I'm pleased to say actually that we go beyond the limit to implementation of the treaty and legislation related to disabled people in our implementation, and in particular agencies are seeking out frequently to representation from disabled people on broader policy that they're undertaking. I know the office is very busy handing on invitations and seeking disabled people, including tangata whaikaha, into those forums to inform broader government policy. But in terms of coming back to the focus on disability policy and legislation and implementing the convention, it's always a certainty, I would expect. You may well bring up an exception, which I'm worried about, where that doesn't happen. To speak to that, I think I'll hand over to Julia Bergman in terms of the, as an illustration of that, in terms of the preparation for the new ministry and accessibility legislation and the Ministry of Health to talk to enabling good lives, governance and system transformation in mid-central as examples of where tangata whaikaha are absolutely designed into those developments. So Julia, calling on you.
Kia ora, Brian, and thank you for the question. Achieving better outcomes for disabled people, tangata whaikaha Māori and whānau, depends on transforming how government works with them. So we know the disability system prevents barriers for many disabled people, tangata whaikaha Māori and whānau whaikaha Māori. Supports and services are fragmented across multiple agencies, and barriers to accessibility also make it harder for people to navigate the system and to participate in everyday life. It is clear that disability support services have not served tangata whaikaha Māori and whānau hoa, and work on transforming these services has been ongoing, led by the Ministry of Health, for more than a decade, underpinned by the vision of enabling good lives. So as members of the IMM Forum will know well, the introduction of enabling good lives approach has changed not just how supports are provided, but also the relationship between the disability community, tangata whaikaha Māori, whānau and the government. So through this work, the disability community has challenged the government to be much more aspirational and to have ambition that was about more than just services, focused on truly transforming the way government serves disabled people, tangata whaikaha Māori, families and whānau. So this push for a bigger ambition is what ultimately led to the establishment of the new Ministry for Disabled People. And the same ambition is present in the work to introduce accessibility legislation. We know that tangata whaikaha Māori experience significant systemic inequities and face compounding barriers to accessibility. It is essential that Te Tiriti o Waitangi is given effect throughout the accessibility legislation so that these inequities. Just accessibility legislation will focus on the prevention. Sorry, have I frozen?
Are you right now?
Okay.
We missed a little bit. Yeah.
Apologies. I'll start that part again.
You've frozen again, Julia. You're back.
I might just turn my video off if that's okay with you, Paula, as the chair, just to ensure the internet stability.
Sure, that's fine. Thanks, Julia. Carry on.
Thank you. So the proposed accessibility legislation will focus on the prevention and removal of barriers to ensure disabled people, tangata whaikaha Māori and whānau hauā can participate and access the same opportunities on an equal basis with others. As you will know, Cabinet have agreed to introduce accessibility legislation and agreed to stand up a new Ministry for Disabled People, which signalled the government focus on creating a true partnership and its dedication to upholding and embedding Te Tiriti o Waitangi, the UN CRPD, and the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous People. Both accessibility and the new ministry got to this point using existing partnership mechanisms. These partnership mechanisms were used to ensure the work was done with disabled people, tangata whaikaha Māori, family and whānau. However, we do acknowledge that this does not go far enough and that the key part of the next stages of this work is to continue to push what it looks like to work in partnership, how we further embed voice mechanisms at every level of the system, and to ensure Te Tiriti o Waitangi is embedded in both the new ministry and the accessibility legislation. We currently have advice before ministers on how to further the relationship with disabled people, tangata whaikaha Māori and whānau, as well as how to embed Te Tiriti o Waitangi, and I'd be pleased to share with you those outcomes once those decisions have been made by government. Kia ora.
Kia ora, thanks, Julia. Someone from the Ministry of Health to talk to the EGL governance and system transformation.
Kia ora koutou. I don't know whether John has come off the call. I hope that you can hear me a bit better than you could hear me in the introductions. Is the sound coming through okay? Okay. So for over a decade, government has been working in partnership with the disability community to transform the disability support system based on the Enabling Good Lives vision and principles. And this work is currently led by the Ministry of Health. The EGL approach supports all disabled people, including tangata whaikaha Māori and their whānau, to have greater choice and control over their supports and lives and to participate and be included in their communities. The EGL principles and approach are strongly aligned with whānau ora. They share a whakapapa. EGL and whānau ora have similar aspirations, including strength based approaches, leadership of individuals and whānau in shaping their own futures, and a commitment to building strong communities and the leadership and capability of individuals and whānau. In October last year, Cabinet agreed to implement the EGL approach to disability support services nationally. feedback from tangata whaikaha me whānau whaikaha Māori involved in the demonstration sites has been positive. Those who have access to the new system report greater ability to manage their own lives and to choose service providers that work within a culturally responsive context. The Ministry of Health's aim is that the programme of work to roll out EGL nationally reflects a partnership between disabled people, tangata whaikaha Māori and the Crown. Governance for the work is provided by the Enabling Good Lives Governance Group, which reflects this tripartite relationship. The group includes representatives from the National Enabling Good Lives Leadership Group, Disabled People, Te Ao Marama, tangata whaikaha Māori, and the Whanaora Interface Group, tangata and whānau whaikaha and Pacific disabled people, alongside cross-government officials. Each workstream within the System Transformation Programme aims to reflect the tripartite relationship through a mix of staff, members of working groups, and technical advisory groups. We know that there is more work to do and that in some parts of the programme, partnership hasn't always been as strong as we would have liked it to have been, and we are committed to continuing to improve that approach as we are in the run-up to the establishment of the new Ministry for Disabled People, which will take over the leadership of the transformation work following its establishment on the 1st of July this year.
Yeah, thanks, Hannah. I'm aware that education and corrections are also here and they may briefly want to speak to the former two questions that we've had.
Kia ora, Brian. Firstly, can you hear me?
Yeah, just, I think we'll get there, yeah.
Okay, we are having network problems in Mātauranga House and dropped out a couple of times, so let's hope the internet holds. I may have missed my cue at question two because some of what I want to say speaks back to the idea of partnership, but it does reflect other elements of the questions as well. So please take it as a little bit of an omnibus. Te Tahu o Te Mātauranga recognises that change is required across all levels of the education system to deliver better outcomes for ākanga Māori and their whānau. We're directed in this regard, amongst other things, by the Education and Training Act 2020 and the Child, Youth and Wellbeing Strategy, which set out clear expectations for the Ministry's work to deliver an education system that honours Te Tiriti or Waitangi and supports all our ākanga to succeed. We also have the Statement of National Education and Learning Priorities, the NELP, which sets out the government's priorities for education that will ensure the success and well-being of all our ākanga, directing early learning services in schools and kura activities towards actions that will make the biggest difference and strengthen the education system to deliver successful outcomes for all our ākanga. Thirdly, we have ka hikitia, ka hapaitia, the Māori Education Strategy, and tau mai te reo, the Māori Language Strategy and Education Strategy, which set out how education agencies and services will work to achieve system shifts in education and support our ākanga Māori and their whānau, hapū and iwi to achieve excellent and equitable outcomes and provide an organising framework for the actions we will take. I've got a couple of instances of work going on within and beyond the Ministry to illustrate how partnership plays an important role in this respect. So within the Ministry has been building capability, cultural capability, by embedding Māori tikanga, using te reo Māori, and undertaking cultural training and forums across our national and regional staff. This is setting the foundations to be able to form positive partnerships with whānau, hapū and iwi across all the work we do. It also sets an important standard to guide the development of policies and legislation. Regarding the wider educational workforce, teachers and kaiako are offered PLD opportunities. Cultural capability is now a new priority area, which focuses on recognising the diversity of students and increasing awareness of practices that perpetuate discrimination, racism, and inequity. I want to now turn to a couple of practical examples of how we are taking work with Māori forward. The first is a piece of co-design work that we have engaged with the Kohanga Rau National Trust on. We began discussions with the trust in 2018 and discovered that we had some shared goals of wanting to do better for the tamariki that they care for. And through a series of wānanga, we came to a joint approach to looking at increased support through learning support for Kohanga Reo and frankly, a better understanding amongst learning support specialists of the needs of Māori learners. So this is about designing a response to mokopuna with communication, behavioural and autism spectrum disorder, or takiwātanga. We held a series of wānanga around the motu, and a co-design approach has been adopted there. Additional funding in 2020 has enabled a second phase of that work, led by the trust and supported by the ministry, which is about strengthening the transition from kohanga to kura, building and strengthening internal and external relationships that enable engagement with kohanga rāua whānau, and developing a model of learning support to ensure that new ways of working are meaningful for te kohanga rāua. So there's been a real merging of worlds in that unique piece of work. Wānanga are also being organised to build the capability of ministry learning support staff to work better with kohanga rāua, their whānau and kaiako. Mention a couple of other pieces of work that reflect the partnership aspect. Huhakina Mai is a culturally responsive approach to supporting positive behaviour. It's part of our positive behaviour for learning stable. It was developed to address the overrepresentation of Māori tamariki in negative school statistics. It's an initiative that promotes whānau, school and iwi working together to build a positive school-wide culture based on a kaupapa Māori worldview. It has been developed with whānau, the Māori educational community, and academic researchers and practitioners, and it is an initiative that is supported and appreciated by hapū and iwi, as it allows for the integration of mana whenua, mātauranga, tikanga, and te reo within schools that sit within the rohi. The other project is Te Mana Tiki Tiki, an evidence-based behaviour intervention program that was developed by Ngāti Whātua Ki Ōrākei and works in partnership with local hapū and iwi. Hakonga Māori are overrepresented in behaviour interventions, but through using a kaupapa Māori approach, Te Mana Tiki Tiki has been increasing self-confidence and self-esteem and improving Hakonga attitudes to their identity, to their Māori identity. Lastly, I just want to mention some work that's being undertaken by Massey University on takiwātanga PLD from a Māori worldview. Again, this is being developed primarily for Kohanga Reo, but will have value beyond that as well. Kia ora.
Kia ora. Thanks, David. Paula, just checking in with you with timing. I think the last two questions, the responses will be a lot briefer to give you a sense of ease, because most of the responses are around these two or three questions two to four. So is that okay? Because I realise Tertiary Education Commission and Corrections hasn't spoken either before we go on to the next question. So over to you, Paula, as chair, and how you want to proceed.
Thanks, Brian. I am very conscious of time, and but we do want to proceed and get through the questions and shorten the break that we have to develop our supplementary questions. So if people are okay, we'll carry on for another 10 minutes and try and get through the remainder of the questions. Could I just ask to assist with that process, if officials were able to take it as read that we are familiar with various policy initiatives, and to try and focus in specifically on how the policy benefits tangata whaikaha Māori or whānau hoa, that just might help with the timeframes. So I'm going to ask now Karen Pointon to ask question four.
Kia ora tātou. Question four. To what extent does the government believe that it has upheld the treaty principles of tino rangatiratanga and the options, and thereby realised Article 30.4 of the UNCRPD in, quote, creating, supporting, and resourcing opportunities for the recognition, but also the expression of being tangata whai kaha Māori, or being whānau hauā, in all aspects of what you might want to see in a person's life. So this is specifically about tangata whai kaha, or whānau hauā. So what has been done in this respect to consider all aspects of their lives? Thank you.
Kia ora, thank you. I'll pass directly to Kelly Bensley from the Office for Disability Issues and in the New Zealand Sign Language Program to talk to this around the work with Tangata Tiriti, and then I'll pass on to Jasmine Morrison to talk about to respond to this in terms of EGL Waikato. Kelly.
Good afternoon, everyone. Tēnā koutou katoa. Thank you for your question, Karen. Māori deaf people are a unique community in that they have a dual cultural identity. They are Māori, but they are also deaf. And that creates all sorts of interesting issues at the intersection of their lives. Many of them have very little access, for example, to te ao Māori due to the lack of accessibility in NZSL, which makes it very difficult for them to develop their Māori identity. The New Zealand Sign Language Board has reflected on this kind of issue and whether the decisions that they were making actually impacted Māori deaf people. And so they sought some advice to consider, for example, how is it that we can meet the needs of Māori deaf people? How can we ensure a partnership approach with Māori deaf people, in particular on the board? And how can we also ensure funding decisions are actually positively impacting Māori deaf people? It's important that Māori deaf people are at the forefront of the leadership of this work. And the advice that was provided said that there needs to be consideration, a minimum really, of two positions on the board for Māori deaf members. And that would ensure that they're involved in decision making and applications for funding that help lead the work that that is relevant for them. The Sign Language Board has also committed to a five-year plan that focuses on Māori deaf people. It will be project-based, and it will provide opportunities for Māori deaf people to develop their skills and capabilities in undertaking this kind of project work to further our aims. What we do, though, recognise is that Māori deaf leaders are, we need more of them. And so we need to engage with Māori deaf people to provide more opportunities for them to get leadership opportunities. So one important project that has begun is a kaitiaki kind of project where this separate group will provide advice directly to the board with a commitment to doing things in the right way for Māori deaf people. And this advisory group will focus particularly on culturally appropriate, relevant engagement with the Māori deaf community. It will also keep an eye on issues and keep the board up to date with any intelligence that they need to know about. And will be a a way for that intelligence to come from the community directly to the board. We also have the criteria for funding related to projects for Māori Deaf. We'll be just developing a long-term strategy and ensuring that we get the right kind of independent advice for both the board and for ODI. Thank you.
Just writing you a really long text.
Oh, mate, I've got one here on the forum and turned my screen off, but...
Paula, stop talking.
Okay. Oh.
You need to turn your mic off.
Kia ora. Thank you, Kelly. There's a few frozen moments there, but to summarise, the important work that the board's undertaken is recognise that the normal way of doing things wasn't working for Tangata Turi, and a 5-year commitment to Tangata Turi led for Tangata Turi programme of work. Moving to Jasmine to talk about Waikato EGL.
Tēnā koe, Karen, thank you for your question. I'm here to give some really practical examples of how Enabling Good Lives Waikato have put this into practice for tangata whaikaha and whānau. There are 6 main ways that we have done this. One is through our leadership group, where we have ensured that tangata whaikaha and whānau and the Māori voice are at the table, and that that voice is strong, and that it is resourced, and that that voice is at the forefront of what drives our direction. From our leadership group, we have been given 3 key areas that we focus on, and that's to elevate tangata whaikaha, Māori, young children, and people who live in rural areas as the critical groups that we need to engage with. The second way is on the wait list. So we prioritise tangata whaikaha, Māori, and their whānau so that they are able to access the option of Enabling Good Lives and the support. The third way is through tūhono Māori. We have been really intentional and had targeted recruitment for Māori tūhono or connectors. The value of cultural capability in mātauranga Māori is recognised and valued in our recruitment process. 4, rural areas. We have a focus on rural and isolated areas in the Waikato, and we really needed to have our people in those communities to have access to those whānau, hapū and iwi memberships. What we do know is that we must go to them and not the other way around. The 5th way is disabled people, tangata whaikaha and whānau are in charge. They have the option to use their support budgets flexibly. Simply put, whānau are able to engage supports that they need and when they need them. There's been a real shift from whānau being passive recipients of support services to self-determining stewards of their own resources. 6, the evaluation process. We're constantly checking in to see whether what we are doing is working and always looking at ways that we can improve. An evaluation process that incorporates a kaupapa Māori approach by a Māori evaluator is one way that we do that. We have key information from these evaluations so that we know that 36% of our participants identified as tangata whaikaha or Māori, and 89% of these whānau believe that Enabling Good Lives Waikato has made a lot of difference to them and their whānau. In closing, we always have work to do. We still have a lot of work to do. And if we are brave and we are honest, we would say we haven't done enough. We are always working with Māori to see how things can be done better.
Kia ora, Jasmine. Paula, back to you.
Thanks, Brian. In the interest of time, I'm going to move us on to question 5, and I'm going to turn to Geneva Hakaraia-Tino for that question, please. Geneva.
Kia ora. Question number 5. to what extent does the government believe it has upheld the treaty principles of the guarantee of equity and active protection, and thereby realised Article 31 of the UNCRPD for Tangata Whaikahamori, whānau hou, disabled Māori to self-identify with Te Ao Māori, have that identity collected and used in a disaggregated manner, and have their data contribute to meaningful changes in policy. Thank you.
Kia ora, thank you, Geneva. I'll respond briefly to this question. It's a really important question, and I think it was demonstrated in the response to question one. The ability to have more disability data and disaggregate that by tangata whaikaha whānau has been realised to some extent, and I think full realisation of the benefits of that is still to be achieved in terms of policy and service development.
Brian, was anyone going to add to that, or is that's your answer?
The Ministry of Health might want to add to that in terms of some of the data work that they're doing.
Tēnā koe, Geneva. Nau e pātaingia mai kia tātou. Me kim nau e mau e whakamātoutou mai ia mātou. The Ministry is currently working in partnership with disability community leaders on a project to identify disabled people, including tangata whaikaha, in the National Health Index, and provide a platform for them to record and communicate accessibility needs to health providers. This work will help us realise our obligations under Article 31 of the UNCRPD. The project is currently in the process of establishing a kaupapa Māori working group to explore opportunities to identify tangata whaikaha in a manner consistent with tikanga Māori and to apply a strong te ao Māori lens across the wider work. Identifying disabled people by NHI will also link the disability community more strongly with other data projects at the Ministry. In particular, the Ministry is undertaking a project which aims to identify which iwi and hapu people affiliate with. This information will combine with disability data to identify disabled people within iwi and hapu to inform solutions by both government and by iwi, hapu and Māori. Kia ora.
Kia ora, John. Paula, back to you.
Kia ora, Brian. John, just a clarifying question, sorry. Were there any timeframes attached to that specific initiative?
I might have to come back with you. They're live at the moment, Paula, sure. But I'm happy to come back to you with timeframes around the work and a bit more around the I think there's three major work streams, if that's useful for you.
Okay, that would be good to come back. Thanks. Thanks, John. We can follow up later. Okay, and I'm going to move on to our final question six, which I will pass to Dr. Huhana Hickey.
Kia ora. Kia ora koutou. What targeted action or actions has the government taken to identify inequitable socioeconomic outcomes and to realise and sustain equity for tangata whaikaha, Māori, whānau hauā, or disabled Māori in New Zealand, in Aotearoa, New Zealand? Thank you.
Kia ora, Huhana. I'll respond to that question. First of all, I'd like to acknowledge your work in terms of the welfare reform work that you influenced, and I think speaking to the people at MSD, continue to influence in your own inimitable informal way. Yeah. In response to your question, and again referring back to the data that was presented in the answer to question one, we need to acknowledge that there are inequitable socioeconomic outcomes for tangata whaikaha Māori. disabled Māori in New Zealand. So firstly, we need to acknowledge that. There are a range of work programs being implemented across government. For example, in the Disability Action Plan, the Māori Employment Action Plan led by MB has a focus on tangata whaikaha Māori. The work in education, the Disability Employment Action Plan, the accessibility work programs, all of them at some time are intended to benefit the socioeconomic outcomes of tangata whaikaha. But to be honest and to speak directly to your question, there is no direct actions in the welfare reform work related to tangata whaikaha. Again, there's the underlying assumption that the broad range of work that's happening in the welfare reforms will benefit all. But again, to speak directly to your question and to be very honest, there are no specific actions related to tangata whaikaha. Paula, back to you. I realise Tertiary Education Commission and Corrections haven't spoken. They may want to speak very briefly in terms of the preparations that they've done and their commitment to this forum. So I'd like to offer that chance if possible before we move into the next stage.
Sure, thanks, Brian. Go ahead.
Paula, did you want to comment?
Thank you, David. I'll keep it really, really brief because we've got a session with the panel on Wednesday where there'll be a much more sort of detail opportunity to put more detail into the specific activities in the tertiary system. There are lots of them. But to Paula's question, how are we thinking and around making sure the policies and the system changes are actually achieving an impact for tangata whaikaha Māori. We're putting a lot more emphasis on, through our funding mechanisms at the TEC, we are the tertiary funder for those of you who don't know who we are, on impact analysis and holding tertiary providers to account for specific results for tangata Māori broadly in tangata whaikaha Māori, and those will be, they are being hardwired into all of our system levers so that if, so that there will be consequences if there are not improvements in equity results for tangata whaikaha Māori. That's probably, I think given the time, Paula, it's probably just leave it there and we can dive a bit more deeper into it in the Wednesday session.
Kia ora,
Paula.
To corrections briefly, Juanita.
Thank you. Well, I will take the advice you gave at the beginning that the IMM are aware of key strategies, and of course, as I talked about at the outset, our strategy Hōkairangi for Arapautama is a tuakana strategy for other strategies and action plans that we undertake within corrections. So if there is a desire to learn more about that, I'm happy perhaps after the break to share a little bit more about that. As I said, the heart of that is oranga, or the well-being and wellness of people. A number of pieces of work have come out of that, which puts a mātauranga Māori perspective and at the heart of what we are doing. And if I to speak to some specific examples, as you've also invited, one of the key things that we have been focused on is developing a new therapeutic models of care, working with mana whenua to develop new services informed by mātauranga Māori across the system. And an example of this is at the Waikiria redevelopment, where we have 600 new beds within the prison there. There is going to be a 100 bed mental health unit called Te Wai Opuri, which will service men in the central region, but also be a central region mental health and addiction services for individuals also in the other two prisons. And the operating model and the implementation plan were developed with mana whenua and the district health board. So there'll be an inner perpetuity, a relationship and a partnership between all three entities, I should say. We're also designing, as part of Hōkairangi, one of the actions is for Arapautama to have a Kaupapa Māori Health Service. So you will all be aware of the statistics that around 52% of people in our prisons are Māori. This will be the health service for Arapotama. There will not be two. We are currently in the information collecting phase of this. We've set up a governance group so that we can start to determine how this might best look within different regions and parts of the country, but specifically within the prison context, that we are working to ensure with equity for Māori of outcomes and Paiora at the centre of that strategy, that we are doing all we can to improve the outcomes for Māori within the within corrections services. Alongside that, we have developed an outcomes dashboard. So previously we have not had a clear way of understanding the impact that we're having in terms of the health services that we're delivering for people in prisons. We've been very specific to disaggregate Māori data from non-Māori data and for Pacifica as well, so that we can start to understand and track the needs of, from a physical health perspective and a mental health perspective, how we are impacting with our service delivery on Māori versus non-Māori and Pacifica as well. We've also commenced using the Washington Group short set as a way of screening people coming into our prisons so that we have a better understanding of the level of functional impairment. We also undertake an interview and a screen when people are coming into prisons as well. And that provides us with some statistics, some population level statistics that is assisting us to develop the disability action plan. But again, with the Washington short set information, we've also disaggregated that. So we've got an understanding of where the needs are for Māori, non-Māori, non-Pacifica and Pacifica. Within the next 6 months, we are hoping to have shaped up the disability action plan for Arapotama. We have not had an action plan within our service for people with disabilities before. We are going through a consultation process and a shaping up of that now, which will include engaging with people in our prisons who have disabilities around the care and services they expect with their whānau and with a number of health and disability agencies outside of Arapotama.
Kia ora. Thank you. Kia ora, Juanita, back to you, Paula.
Kia ora, Brian. Nga mihi nui, everybody. Thank you for all of those responses from the government. In the interests of time, I've just liaised with our interpreters and our technology platform and Brian to see if we could take a 10-minute break now, which will allow officials to do what you need to do, and for the IMM Aropu to stay and develop the supplementary questions. And if everybody could come back at 10 past three, and then we will resume the final part of our session. So we'll take a 10-minute break now, and if the IMM could remain online, nga mihi.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. 60 seconds.
Kia koutou katoa, ko Paula Tesoriero toko ingoa. Welcome back. I'm Paula Tesoriero, the Disability Rights Commissioner, and I am chairing this final part of our second session of the IMM Domestic Forum and Dialogue with the New Zealand Government. Welcome back, everybody. Apologies, we are running 10 minutes behind time, but we will be aiming to finish this session at between 10 past and quarter past four this afternoon. Thank you to the government officials for coming and participating in this really important session where there will be some dialogue between the IMM and between government. Can I just make a couple of very quick remarks, which is just in terms of how we run this session, for each of the main questions that we asked the government earlier, members of the IMM, Tiriti Ropu, will ask one to two supplementary questions off the back of that main question, and that's in response to what we heard this afternoon and questions that the Ropu would like to ask. In the interest of time, can I ask government officials to limit your responses to approximately 1 minute? I know that puts some pressure on you, but that way we can get through as many supplementary questions as possible. So I will now hand over to Mātua Tristram for the first set of questions and introductory remarks. Nā mihi, Tristram.
Kia ora, Paula, and thank you for that. And I just, before we begin, I just want to note for our audience today that these questions posed by our panel today are really addressed to the Crown, the government, and are really more appropriately directed to ministerial level. So the panel wish to highlight the relevant portfolios that our questions are directed to, and those include the Prime Minister, Minister for Child Poverty Reduction, Minister for Crown Māori Relations, Te Arawhiti, the Minister for Children, Corrections, the Minister for Housing, Minister for COVID-19 Response, Education, Public Service, Minister for Health, Treaty of Waitangi Negotiations, Minister for Whānau Ora, Minister for Māori Development, Minister for Prevention and Family Sexual Violence, and the Minister for Statistics. We do note with disappointment that none of the ministers are present today, but we do really want to recognise the government officials who are present, but just to note that they may be limited in what they can say in response to some of these questions, these supplementary questions. Nevertheless, again, the IMM want to thank them and look forward to constructive engagement on these important issues. And we will undertake to follow up any responses that do need clarity in due course. Kia ora. So question one was about the overall realisation of the CRPD for tangata whai kaha Māori. And it was about equity, the full and equal enjoyment of all human rights and fundamental freedoms. In the government's principal response, we did hear of a commitment to realising the CRPD, but noting that that was a progressive realisation. We just want to be clear, the government's commitment to realising the CRPD has already been clearly expressed in its initial commitment on signing the convention back in March 2007. Further, in ratifying it in December of the same year, and on the optional protocol signing accession in 2016. So the convention itself has been in effect for some 15 years. At the time of ratifying, the government stated its laws were broadly consistent with the provisions of the convention. Yet today, inequities for tangata whakaha Māori remain entrenched and pervasive. So given the UNCRPD is an international convention that has not been domesticated into New Zealand law, the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples is a non-binding declaration. Te Tiriti o Waitangi is not legislated and the Waitangi Tribunal's findings are non-binding. How does the government intend to safeguard the rights of tangata whakaha Māori in legislation? Kia ora.
Brian, can I turn to you in the first instance?
Yeah, okay. I think there's a similar question to this in a, one of the other forums, and I think the Ministry of Justice will respond to this question around how the UNCRPD can be embedded within legislation. So I won't preempt the answer to that question. I think that's on the, in one of the other forums, Tristram. So rather than preempt what they might, how they might respond to that question, I'll pass on that. So my apologies on that.
Can I add something to that, Brian?
Yep, yep.
So certainly in the context of the Pai Order legislation and Pai Order Bill, there's a very clear and strengthened articulation of the place and position of Te Tiriti o Waitangi in health, and certainly Māori health equity. And it's very clear in the legislation that that's tied to government having clear strategies for Māori, Pacifica and disabled peoples. So it doesn't address the point you made, Tristram, about the UN Convention and how that's recognised and provided for, but certainly in the context of the health legislation that's currently going through the House, there's a very clear intention to strengthen the position of Te Tiriti o Waitangi in health, and a very clear intention to strengthen the focus on equity, including making sure that we provide for Māori, Pacifica and disabled peoples.
Thanks, John. And Claudia, are you here? Because I believe the UNCRPD is identified in the Oranga Tamariki Act.
I am here. I'm getting some information from my people, but I would say that Oranga Tamariki has, in recognition of the number of children in care who are disabled and the number of children in care who are Māori and Pacific, it's disproportionate. So we have established roles for Chief Advisor, Chief Advisor Pacific, Potikanga, and Chief Advisor Disability, so that we can give advice directly to the Chief Executive and directly to DEPSEC level, to lift the voices of our own people, but also together to raise and address the intersectionality and the severe disadvantage that comes from that.
Yeah.
Disability support needs are called out in our legislation. And 7AA, section 7AA, assigns specific duties to the Chief Executive in relation to Te Tiriti, including all tamariki and rangatahi.
Kia ora. And the additional response I would make, Tristram, is while it might not be identified in legislation, the guidelines from DPMC in terms of papers going to cabinet identify that disabled people as a population group need to be considered within all those cabinet decisions. I know that's not as strong as legislation, but cabinet decisions are kind of next level down.
And just thinking, Brian, about the intersectionality that occurs, We know that Māori in general are finding increasing voice in legislation. Disabled people also, to a lesser extent, given voice. But what about the intersectionality that provides a central voice for tangata whaikaha Māori, where it's not just being Māori and not just being disabled, but it's both?
Sure. I'll let Juanita respond and then I'll make a comment too, which won't entirely satisfy you, but is the best comment I can make.
Aroha mai, neither will mine, Mata or Tristram. I was just going to add probably a similar thing to what John said, that Corrections is also exploring options to amend the Corrections Act 2004 for provisions to be made for Te Tiriti or Waitangi, including the requirements in relation to partnership with Māori. The next step for us is cabinet consideration and further consultation with iwi Māori partners and public consultation. But again, it doesn't talk to the important point that you have asked of us.
Yeah. And so Tristram, again, just a comment on the intersectionality and cabinet level decisions. For example, the New Zealand Sign Language Board, from the minister and from cabinet, it makes it clear that there should be tangata turi within the New Zealand Sign Language Board. And I believe, and we can't talk to that, is that legislation that's under consideration around accessibility, and the new ministry also gives consideration to those things. So not in legislation, but certainly identified within cabinet decisions.
Kia ora. So things that don't have a home tend not to get done. The question really is, who in government has the primary responsibility or the sector stewardship role for tangata whaikaha Māori? Where does the accountability lie across government for outcomes for tangata whaikaha Māori specifically?
So I'll wait and see if there's anyone else that would want to respond to that.
Brian, would you like me to pick that question up?
Thanks, Julia.
Julia speaking. In response to that question, Tristram, I would say that's a key role and one of the key reasons why the new Ministry for Disabled People is being established, because that doesn't exist currently and it's incredibly important. And a key part of what that new ministry needs to establish early on is, what does that tripartite relationship look like? What does that look like for Māori, tangata whaikaha Māori, and government? What does that relationship look like, and how will that ministry establish that tripartite relationship and therefore hold that stewardship role with that partnership for tangata whaikaha Māori?
Thank you, Julia.
And the point I was at would add, Tristram, is responsibilities for disabled people, tangata whaikaha Māori, must not reside totally within the new ministry. It actually must reside as the responsibility of every ministry and every key policy that every ministry is planning and implementing.
Kia ora, Brian, I completely agree.
Kia ora.
Brian, I was just going to add to that too. Tristram. I was just going to add to that too by saying that obviously in the context of the Ministry of Health stewardship role in the health system, we still have responsibilities for tangata whaikaha. But it really picks on Brian's point, which is the lead now will be with the new ministry across government, but each of the ministries of government will be required to continue to do their work in their respective sectors. And certainly for health, there'll be a big job for us to continue to do to make sure we're supporting tangata whaikaha.
Thanks, John.
My sort of final question then on this thing that really links to the fact that tangata whaikaha say we are Māori first, disabled second. So how do the Māori portfolio ministers work collaboratively with each other and with tangata whaikaha Māori to improve outcomes for tangata whaikaha Māori?
Um, probably a disappointing response, but I won't talk for those ministers, Tristram. But you were at the Ministerial Leadership Group meeting at the end of last year when two of the ministers, Minister Davis and Minister Jackson, expressed interest in terms of how their portfolios might better address the needs of tangata whaikaha Māori. So I would say the IMM has awoken interest amongst ministers.
Kia ora. Thank you. In the interest of time, I'll rest here.
Kia ora, Tristram. Thanks for those responses. Can I just ask in this session, because it's less clearer than earlier, who is speaking to ensure that this forum is accessible for all people who are listening, could you please say your name and your agency before you respond, just so that it is accessible for everyone? I'm now going to move on to Peter Allen to ask the second supplementary question. Mātua, Peter.
Kia ora, Paula. Kia ora, koutou. I have the second question, and that is about self-determination for tangata whaikaha Māori and whānau haua. And it's based around three main areas, and that's self-organising, collectively determining priorities, and exerting rangatiratanga over our own lives. So what we are talking about here is the first question I have is around funding and resourcing. So how does the government fund and resource its obligations to enable tangata whaikaha Māori and whānau haua to self-organise as articulated in the UN General Comment number 7? And we know, John, that you touched on Te Ao Marama, but it's rather a light example, and so we're just wanting to know if that could be expanded on. And Huatu Taraku Te A Koe, Brian.
Kia ora. So I'll take the initial response on this. Peter, thanks for the question, and John might want to follow up. One of the things that we've absolutely worked on over the last 4 years and made it really clear to government agencies, if they are engaging in an ongoing way with disabled people, including tangata whaikaha, as experts and advisors, that they must be funded as experts and advisors to government. So I would think there are very few ongoing initiatives where tangata whaikaha who are at the table are not being funded. That's slightly different, and I acknowledge, to the standing up of organisations as a representative voice of tangata whaikaha. And I think Te Ao Marama probably gets closest to that, so I will hand the hospital pass to John Whanga.
Kia ora, Brian.
Kia ora koutou. Tēnā nō koe, Peter. Yes, I think a couple of things I'd pause on there. We are, as you said, we are working with Te Ao Marama, and certainly we revised our relationship with them late last year, so we're working with them directly. But I think over and above that, within the whakamau, the Māori Health Direction and Health, our preeminent focus is putting Māori in a position to be able to exercise authority over their health and wellbeing. You'll see a key mechanism of that in the PIO legislation is the establishment of a Māori Health Authority to literally give that entity the ability to commission services under its own mana and utilising mātauranga Māori. So as we move towards that, we'll be working much more, not only with advisory groups such as Te Ao Marama, but having to partner with tangata whaikaha in the development of services. I expect that in the commissioning arrangements for both Health New Zealand and the Māori Health Authority, they will want to explore quite seriously how it is they commission services to support tangata whaikaha and health, and in particular for the Māori Health Authority, how that also gives expression to tino rangatiratanga. But you're quite right, we've got some strong mechanisms in place around advisory functions, which are supporting, but we need to take that the next step, which is partnering. It's not enough to get this advice, unless, I think it was Tristram or someone else said before, we enact it, that we take that advice on board and we change the way we do things.
Kia ora, John.
And again, I just kind of say, looking ahead in terms of the establishment of the new ministry, it's acknowledged that new mechanisms will need to be established there. But all of those things are under active consideration, so we can't go any further.
Kia ora, Brian.
Kia ora, Brian. Tristram speaking again. A question that was offered to us to ask today. How does the government support and resource tangata whai kaha Māori to network, collaborate and fully participate in international Indigenous forums? Kia ora.
Kia ora, Tristram, and the silence in response to that question is probably the answer. Either we don't know or it's not happening. We'll come back to you on that. What I take from your question is a desire for government to do that.
Kia ora, yes, I understand that that is a long-held desire. Kia ora.
Ko mutu tātou nei taku pātai, Paula, o ki aku.
Thanks, Peter. I'm going to move on now to our next set of supplementary questions in relation to the main third question. So I'm going to turn to Bernadette Jones.
Got it, Paula. And these supplementary questions refer to my original question three, which is about the voice and being at the table and how government seeks, receives and implements tangata whai kaha Māori whānau hoa perspectives in the development of all legislation, policies and decision making. And perhaps John, you may wish to answer this one. Also here, looking at the intersectionality of Māori and disability, we note there is no explicit tangata whai kaha Māori representation on the interim boards in New Zealand Health or Māori Health Authority. Disappointingly also, there is little mention of tangata whai kaha Māori within the draft Pai Ora legislation, despite direct advice from tangata whai kaha Māori being at the table and providing advice to this. It would be really good to hear a response from you about perhaps how this could be addressed moving forward and how tangata whai kaha Māori decision making can be prioritised in this legislation. Kia ora.
Kia ora. Tēnā nō koe. I think the first point I'd make is that the Pai Ora, you're right, the Pai Ora legislation doesn't have a number of provisions which directly relate to tangata whai kaha. But as I said, there is a preeminent clause in there which says that there needs to be a clear disability strategy, and that strategy needs to be incorporated in the government policy statement, which sets the direction from the minister for, I think it's 3 to 5 years in front. So it's a critical part of that work. I think on top of that though, I'm not sure I can answer your questions about the composition of the Māori Health Authority Board or Health New Zealand, but I would say this, that the government is going through the process. They are currently interim appointments, so the government is looking at where the permanent appointments might be for those positions. And I can certainly say from both my engagements with the Board of Health New Zealand and the Māori Health Authority, they are very clear that they wish to push equity in Te Tiriti o Waitangi at the centre of what it is they do, particularly around commissioning and co-commissioning. I don't think they've had the opportunity yet to delve deeper to understand the different equity considerations they need to meet, including treaty considerations they need to meet, including for tangata whai kaha. So, yeah, sorry, I can't really answer your question on behalf of government about the composition of government boards, but I can say they're interim at the moment. The government is going through a process to formalise those appointments over the next little while. And I can also say, in terms of my engagement with both Health New Zealand and the Māori Health Authority, they are very clear and purposeful about putting both Te Tiriti o Waitangi and Māori Health Equity at the centre of what they do. And for me, that provides a huge opportunity to advance tangata whai kaha, amongst others.
Kia ora, John. And my next supplementary question, under question three, I'll direct perhaps to you, Julia, because you highlighted the National EGL Governance and System Transformation, citing the EGL Waikato program as a successful example of improving outcomes for about 33%, I think you said, of tangata whai kaha Māori. We're interested to explore a bit more, why was this approach not used in the other two EGL sites? And those sites, we understand the outcomes were not nearly as successful as the Waikato demonstration was for tangata whai kaha Māori, with I think approximately 16% of Māori engaging in the mid-central demonstration. And how will government ensure equity in the future national EGL rollout for tangata whai kaha Māori? Kia ora.
Kia ora, Julia speaking. Thank you for that question. At the risk of sounding like I'm palming this off, I will have to put that question to Health, because Health do have responsibility for the other EGL demonstrations as well as the system transformation. So perhaps somebody like Erin Black might like to respond to that question.
Kia ora tātou, ngā mihi nui ki a koe whae Bernadette. So there's a number of things that we can do to ensure equity, particularly in reference to the national scaling of the Enabling Good Lives approach. For myself, part of that is having tangata whai kaha in our leadership roles, in our chair roles, and being able to lead from the front. That's when we'll really see equity in action, and also being included in important decision-making functions. So I think for me, it's a continued focus on making sure that we have diversity, cultural diversity, within our leadership mixes and also involved in governance. And certainly also a key learning, particularly from the prototype in Mana Whai Kaha, is really good early engagement with iwi and hapu, which will also be making a priority in terms of any future scaling of new locations and regions within the national scaling. So just a couple of really high level, but I think important points that we can take from the demonstration and prototype sites. But going back to, I think, the initial comment, we do still have a lot of work to do. Kia ora.
Kia ora, Erin.
If I can just add to that, we really need to look carefully at how EGL Waikato was implemented, and look at the evaluation work that was done around that, and we need to give kind of honour the voices of tangata whai kaha in that demonstration project to make sure that the good things there actually inform as EGL is taken to scale.
Kia ora, Brian.
Namahi, Brian and Bernadette. I'm going to move on now to the next supplementary questions, and I'm going to ask Ronell Baker to lead those. Kia ora, Ronell.
Tēnā tātou anō. So I am talking to question four. Question four is about identity, creating, supporting and resourcing opportunities for recognition and expression of being tangata whai kaha Māori or whānau hauā in all aspects of our lives. We've heard some responses and examples given around particularly the New Zealand Sign Language Board and the five-year commitment to tangata tiri and whānau tiri. We've heard the example of the Enabling Good Lives initiative, in particular the Waikato work, and how that is demonstrating good outcomes. We really want to reinforce that being a tangata whaikaha Māori is more than just being disabled or receiving disability supports, and really wanting to think about future casting as well. So about upcoming legislation, how we can be recognised in those spaces more appropriately. But I'd like to hand over to my whanaunga Karen to ask a supplementary question under question four.
Kia ora. Okay, so one question that always comes up is regarding the UN Convention, and you know, it's always talking about international languages and also national languages too. So if we think about Aotearoa with Te Reo Māori and also with New Zealand Sign Language, and thinking about the New Zealand Sign Language Act of 2006 specifically, and how that became law, and you know, we gained official recognition of our language. So the question's been asked as to whether the government is doing enough to promote New Zealand Sign Language and to embed this into basically across all government agencies. So that is the question that I would like to pose, be thought about. Second to that is in terms of the health services, hospitals, GPs, in general, the health services, just thinking about how we might promote New Zealand Sign Language and its usage by professionals, and just thinking about deaf people and how just where the responsibility lies in terms of the booking out of interpreters that is not with our tangata turi themselves. And I believe that all health or you know, medical agencies out there need to make sure that they are booking interpreters and taking responsibility for that under the New Zealand Sign Language Act to ensure clear communication. So this question applies to all government agencies really, including disability sector, the supports and services out there all over New Zealand. And yeah, so really it's just about asking what is being done and whether there is legislation in terms of responsibility and where that lies over, you know, linked to New Zealand Sign Language Act 2006. So please, for the future of our tangata turi and their education and their access to language learning, work needs to be done, and for Māori deaf too. Kia ora.
Kia ora, Karen. I'll respond to that, and Kelly might want to add something. I do note that later in the forum, under the accessibility kaupapa, there are questions around the New Zealand Sign Language, and at that point we will speak to the New Zealand Sign Language strategy and the work that's happening under the board and under the minister for that. Part of that work is, as you've identified, really thinking, does the Act currently give all the powers and supports that people would expect, and that is part of the work program. I think one of the things I think I'll leave it, because you actually can't take one part of the strategy. You need to think about standards, you need to think about growing the NZSL workforce, as well as creating accountability on every agency to ensure their services are accessible, in particular for tangata whaikaha through sign language. And so I can't give you much detail other than I think I was speaking in code that there really is some consideration of whether the Act actually gives all the power and opportunities that we would want.
Thank you, Brian. It's Ronelle speaking. I'm just aware that that question was also in regards to resources and accountability. Who's taking responsibility for ensuring that that resource is provided and that the burden doesn't fall back on tangata tiriti themselves?
Kia ora. So I'll talk to that. It's really clear from the NZSL board's perspective and within the NZSL Act, that is the agency must take responsibility for the provision of interpreters. It is made very clear in terms of the justice system and through judicial hearings that NZSL interpreters must be available. It is not as clear and accountable for other agencies.
Thank you. Karen, are you happy to move on? Kapai. Thank you. So again, under question four, we've heard a lot about the Enabling Good Lives initiative. Obviously, this will be scaled up and made available to all whānau across the motu. So we're interested in hearing how has the government involved other hapū, iwi and tangata whai kaha Māori in other areas of Aotearoa, particularly in rural areas where there are where there is more experience of inequity. How have these communities been engaged and prepared for the national rollout of EGL to ensure the success of that initiative?
Good. I think that might sit with Erin and possibly Julia.
Kia ora anō. So in terms of work that's been done to date, there was a national program of capability and capacity development for Enabling Good Lives called 10AO. This program of forum and wānanga also provided a series of hui for mana whenua based all around Ōtautahi, so Whangarei, Tauranga Moana, down to Murihiku. Those hui concluded I think in the middle of last year. We will be looking to reconvene those again. Certainly the feedback that was received and actually I think Ike was a facilitator of some of those hui, the kia ora hoa, feedback that we received was that the by Māori, for Māori approach that was taken to those hui and also providing a space where tangata whaikaha and whānau whaikaha could bring their mamai and actually start to address the realities before they could move on and start to realise the opportunities for the future were valuable and something that we'll seek to replicate and provide further opportunities for in addition to the obvious increasing of the capability and capacity to be able to utilise the Enabling Good Lives approach, both from a personal perspective, but also a community and whānau perspective. Julia, I'm not sure if there's anything from your perspective on that.
Julia speaking. Kia ora, Erin. No, I think you've covered that off well. Thank you.
Kia ora, it's Ronelle speaking. So I'll hand back to the chair just to transition to the next question.
Kia ora, Ronelle. So moving us to some supplementary questions around question five, and I'm going to hand to Geneva and Ronelle.
Kia ora anō. So I will just introduce supplementary question five and then hand over to my whanaunga Geneva. So just to recap, question five is about data and evidence. Having tangata whai kaha Māori identity, our data collected, used in a disaggregated manner and having that data contribute to meaningful changes in policy. So we have heard some examples, particularly from the Office for Disability Issues with regards to the data that they are publishing today. And I'm now going to hand over to Geneva to ask the supplementary question.
Tang Nga Te Whai Kaha Mori to inform public policy and the delivery of services. Kia ora. Stats New Zealand have responsibility for the management of a number of statistical collections that have a role to identify. Tang Nga Te Whai Kaha Mori to inform public policy and the delivery of services. Why does government policy and resourcing allow a structural bias that sees Te Kupina, the Mori survey, being run alternate within 5 years apart from the New Zealand Disability Survey, meaning there is never a comprehensive measure of Tang Nga Te Whai Kaha Mori experience? Thank you.
Kia ora, in the absence of Stats New Zealand, I'll partially answer this question. The timing of Te Kupinga and the New Zealand Disability Survey every 10 years, I think we would say is difficult. It's really difficult in 2024. I think it'll be 2024. We will still be quoting data from the 2013 Disability Survey. However, the fact that Statistics New Zealand uses the Washington short set of questions in all of the surveys that they use, like the Household Labour Force Survey, the June Quarter Survey, and then the Wellbeing Surveys, gives us a lot more data now between censuses than we would have had in the past. I think if Stats New Zealand were here, they would say that using the New Zealand Disability Survey every 10 years, the kind of things that they measure in that survey don't significantly change within 5 years. But that's a question for statisticians, and one that if Dr. Jonathan Godfrey was on this this part of the forum would, I think, discuss and debate. I think the good thing is, Geneva, is that lots of government agencies are now using the Washington set of questions in the surveys that they're using, like the Crime and Victimisation Survey, the Health Survey. This is giving us really rich data that doesn't just rely on the New Zealand Disability Survey and Te Kupinga.
Kia ora, it's Ronelle speaking. So thank you, Brian, for your response. In the interest of time, I might hand back to the chairperson so that we can ensure that we cover supplementary question six.
Oh, Ronelle, I forgot that you're from Stats New Zealand. Could you answer your own question?
I declined to due to a conflict.
Kia ora, Ronelle. And turning to our final set of supplementary questions, I'm going to ask Dr. Huhana Hickey. Kia ora, Huhana.
Kia ora. Okay, question six is about economic wellbeing, identifying inequitable socioeconomic outcomes and realising the sustaining equity for tangata whai kaha Māori, whānau hawa, disabled Māori and Aotearoa. I've got two supplementaries here. 6.1, Welfare Expert Advisory Group and its Whakamana Tangata report noted that living in poverty often results in long-lasting, poorer outcomes for, well, whānau hawa, Māori, including specifically the cognitive, emotional, and behavioural development of children. They also noted emerging evidence of poverty's negative effects on the mental health of people of all ages. Does the government recognise the critical and time-sensitive need to eradicate child poverty to prevent the future ballooning of disability among our most vulnerable?
marginalised, especially tamariki Māori? Thank you.
Kia ora, Brian speaking. Huhana, this is a question again that I think sits within tomorrow's forum in terms of the poverty theme there. And a similar question has been asked in that forum around children and, yeah, so I think best to leave that answer to there, if that's okay. I kind of acknowledge your wisdom on this as well.
I guess I'll just add that on the 1st of April, there are increases in the SLP and all the benefits, but I note that SLP received less than any of the other beneficiaries getting their increases. I realise it's all down to formulas, but it's just furthering the poverty of disabled and disabled Māori in particular. Anyway, okay, thank you for that. Supplementary 6.2, the Welfare Expert Advisory Group report made 42 key recommendations, not directly affecting tangata whaikaha or whana hawa. The WEAG has recently reported, and we did, that it considers the majority of these recommendations have not been fully implemented. When does the government intend implementing the recommendations, please?
Kia ora, Brian speaking. Again, that's a question that I think we'll sit with tomorrow. I have actually heard the Minister for Social Welfare respond to this question, and there is a commitment to progressing the realisation of those recommendations, and they can't all be done at once.
Thank you.
Kia ora, Brian, Tristram here. Just on behalf of the audience who may be attending today, because they're tangata whaikaha Māori and whānau hawa, can we employ you to give something of a response to this question? Otherwise, I think tangata whaikaha get marginalised within a mainstream response to even a disability question.
Yeah, sorry, Tristram, unless there's someone else from MSD that can actually talk to this question, I wouldn't want to confound people by giving the wrong answer.
Yeah, my apologies, Julia speaking from MSD. I'm not in a position to answer this question either. We have prepared the relevant people for tomorrow, so apologies for that.
Okay, can I just check, Huhana, are you okay for us to move on, or did you have a, okay.
No point. There's no point in addressing the issue. It's been almost five years and we're still waiting, but the WEAG group will keep lobbying the Prime Minister and the MPs.
Kia ora, Huhana. Before I make some final comments and hand over to Matua Ike. Matua Tristram, did you have anything that you wish to say before I wrap up?
Kia ora. Just the final comment and question really. Whānau today have heard a lot of things that are happening, a lot of good things, and there are positive changes happening. I guess just coming back to our fundamental question for the day, I'd kind of like to sort of really strip away perhaps some of the, you know, there's a lot of bits and pieces going on. The convention's been in effect for some 15 years. I think I heard a narrative that was saying there is much to do. How does the government rate itself on what it has done? You know, in legal speak, we talk about progressive realization of this convention, but actually progressive realization is hard to measure, as you've addressed, and particularly when there aren't legislative mechanisms to push change, there isn't a clear single point of focus within government to do that. The people, the communities who need to be at the table are often not resourced equitably to be there. How does government summarise its action over that 15 years? How would you say to the audience, what's really changed for tangata whai kaha Māori over that time? Kia ora.
Kia ora, Brian speaking. I'm just looking across the screen to see if anyone else is going to respond to that. Mātua Tristram. Okay, so Brian speaking. I would refer back to the things that the minister said this morning. I would refer to the annual report to Parliament tabled by the minister each year on progression of actions to realise the convention. So those are on record over the last 5 years, at least last 5 years in terms of the actions that are completed. The other thing I would say, and I say this really sincerely, because I was involved in 2014 in terms of the last time that the government was examined by the UN, the questions asked today are very different to the questions that were asked then. The answers that have been given today are very different to the answers. I don't think we would have had answers to those questions in 2014. So how do we know? The best way that we know, and I think the theme that comes through from the forum this afternoon, is continued engagement of tangata whai kaha at the policy tables. I think the reason why statistics and disaggregation of disability data is so important under the convention is because that becomes another way, that is another part of the voice that actually gives us confidence or otherwise that things are being progressed.
Kia ora, Brian. And just before I make some final process comments before tomorrow, I think Bernie from the IMM Ropu would like to comment.
Kia ora, Paula. I'd just like to particularly thank, and I know you did earlier, Paula, you made mention of the many hours that this tangata whai kaha ropu have put into this. And it's yet again another example of structural discrimination. We were not included at the beginning of this. We were brought on at the end of this process, and I would really value the way of working forward, and particularly discuss a way with perhaps you, Brian, how Māori disabled-led organisations can be part of a more formal coalition. I do know that there is no Māori disabled organisations within the coalition, and hence that's probably why tangata whai kaha voices were not at the table in the IMM planning of this, or perhaps there was one person, but Tristram was there representing muscular dystrophy, not a Māori disabled organisation. So I'd really value an opportunity to very urgently look at a way that we can address this, because we have come to this IMM and been disadvantaged in being here. And I think this needs urgent addressing. But I want to thank the Ropu for giving up their time and dropping their mahi at the last minute to be a part of this. We really value your input. Kia ora.
Kia ora, Bernadette. I'm not sure if you wanted to say anything in response, Brian. I might move us. Okay.
Kia ora, Bernie, for those comments. Ngā mihi, everybody, for all of the effort that has gone in today from Brian, your leadership and government officials, and just underscoring the thanks that I made earlier, and Bernie has also emphasised the thanks to you, Mātua Tristram, for your leadership of this rōpū, and for the time and energy that has gone in by tangata whaikaha Māori, whānau, hoa, into making this a successful dialogue in terms of having some interaction. Just a plea for the remainder of our forum. We've got three more days spread over the next week. And can I just note that there were some references today in responses from government that some things would be addressed later in the forum. So the last one, for example, that things would be addressed in tomorrow's poverty session. Can I just make a plea that government officials answering questions tomorrow do pay particular attention to specifying your answers in relation to how they address the needs of tangata whaikaha Māori and whānau hoa. And can I make another plea that in responses tomorrow, that where you can you, I really ask that your questions be very, very focused and explicit on how the government's responses address the needs of disabled people and tangata whaikaha Māori. So the more specificity in your responses, the more helpful that is for us in our monitoring. I know some have attempted to do that today, and so thank you for that, but some were very generic answers, and we just hope as the forum moves on that we can get more specificity, and particularly that any responses where you have deferred from today to tomorrow or later in the forum, that you do honour those questions for or responses rather, that there's specificity for tangata whaikaha Māori and whānau hoa. So again, ngā mihi nui, thank you everybody. I'm now going to pass to Mātua Ike to close us out for this really significant occasion. Kia ora, Mātua Ike, over to you, ngā mihi.
O te rā, tēnā rā tātou katoa. Rā te tuatahi, ko tēnei rā te tuku atu, te mihi kia koe rā e tō tātou. Kai hautū kōrero, te kai hautū tika hauātango, te kāhui tika tangata, te mārei kure e pō. Nā wano i hautū i tō te waka, kia pā e tō tātou me hui mōrera. Ka mihi. First of all, to our chair and steerer of our ship today in this afternoon session, to you, Paula. Thank you for steering this week to where it needed to go today. Ki te pane o te tari mga take hauātanga, me te māngai whakautu mo te kāwanatanga e Brian, piri no ki tō tira hāpai, tēnei te mihi atu ki a kaita katoa. Mai ki atu, kia kaha, kia mana watoa, ki te mahi ngā mahi. So to Brian, Māngai, for government response and your tira of government agencies, we acknowledge you and thank you. We also say, be brave, be bold, be intentional in the actions that you do seeking for. Nō reira, tēnā koutou. E ngā reo mano, e ngā tini mano o te iwi hauā, te iwi whaikaha. Kia kaha ki te whakare arahi i tō tātou reo. Kia rongo ai tēnā me tēnā o ngā minita o te kāwanatanga. Mā te atu anō, ngō tātou reo e whakarahi ake. So to the many voices and the people, and the many people within our iwi haua, our iwi whakaha, I say be strong in amplifying the voices of us and those of our whānau. May God give us the voice to do the things that we have to do to ensure that our voice is heard. Nō reira, ko tēnei rā te mihi atu. Kia koutou. Tēnei rā mātou, no IMM, me tō mātou rangatira a Tristram. E mihi atu, e mihi atu, e mihi atu. So on behalf of te tira Māori o IMM, and of course our rangatira Tristram, we say thank you, thank you, thank you. And may I just end this in saying, kia hora te maru, kia whakapapa paunamu te moana, kia tere te kārohi rohi I mui tō huarai. So may peace be widespread, may the sea glisten like green stone, and may the shimmer of light guide you on your way to supporting us. Piri nō, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, and just allow me to close in short prayer. Kia inoi tātou. Kia tātou katoa, kia tawhai o te api kia I hukaichi, me te aroha o te atua, me te whiwhinga tahitanga ki te wairuatapu. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. Kia ora tātou.